going, Lady Survival here, and today I have a little hair adventure that I'm doing, and I figured I would film it because I've had a few people request for like hair dye stuff. I have the half black, half purple, but my black has kind of faded more to like a brown because it was like a semi-permanent black, which I'm so glad we did because eventually I'm gonna wanna change it again, but yeah. So I got it done professionally, actually by my fiance's sister, who is a hairstylist. So she did it for me and I freaking love it, but I do want it to be more like black, just so that it matches a little better, because basically, here, let me take out, I put it in a side ponytail because it looks so bad. So these are my extensions. I'm just wearing like one weft right now because I was just wearing a side ponytail. But you can see that my extensions are significantly more black than my hair, so I just want to get those matching again so that I can be like good to go for going to work and not looking like a weirdo. Yeah, so I went to Sally's and I got a couple things. Here's my little bag. I had to do curbside pickup because Ontario in Canada is on like lockdown right now, so I was so glad that they were even open at all. But yeah, so I picked up two things. I got this Manic Panic Ultraviolet, which is like my favorite purple ever, and I like to dilute it to kind of get a nice like kind of pastel purple kind of color. So originally when I got the purple done, it was like a really kind of dark like deep blue purple, but this time now that it's faded, I kind of just want to do it more like kind of pastel. And then I got this Ion Color Brilliance Semi-Permanent Black. I've never used this one before. I've used other Ion colors from like this line, but never the black one, so we'll see how it goes. I hope that it's gonna be black enough and that it works okay. So yeah, that's pretty much what we're gonna be doing with my hair. And then I went to Walmart to get a big cheap bottle of conditioner. This is what I use to dilute the Manic Panic stuff, so just literally I always just buy whatever random big white conditioner that they have. So as long as it's white, as you can see, then that's good to dilute it with. It doesn't matter the quality, and sometimes I even buy it from the dollar store, but yeah, I just went to Walmart. And then while I was at Walmart, I got two other things, which I've been really excited to try because I've been hearing a lot of good things about them on YouTube and stuff. So I got this Dream Lengths 8-Second Wonder Water Lamellar Rinse Out. I think that's how you say it. So there it is. I heard a lot of good reviews about it on YouTube. It's supposed to make your hair like frizz-free and like damage-free and just like really nice. It says sleek, smooth, length, and seconds. So I figured I would try it because why not? And then I also got this Dream Lengths serum because I'm out of like all of my serums that I've had, and I kind of just wanted something that I can use to kind of calm like frizz and anything, and just kind of, I find serums are really good for hair extensions. So I'm gonna be trying these out too. I don't know if I'm gonna be using these products today though, because after I dye my hair, I don't know if I really want to put like another product into my hair. I'll probably do this like another day, but I will definitely let you guys know about this one. I'm just not sure if I'll do it in this video or not. Yeah, pretty much my plan is to take out my hair extensions, what I will do now, and I'm just gonna pretty much go ahead and dye my hair. So this was the one weft that I had in. It's kind of splotchy. I didn't do that good of a job dyeing these, but I need to get new extensions soon anyways. But when I'm done dyeing my own hair, whatever leftover I have, I'll probably put on top of this purple to kind of hopefully make it sort of match the purple that I'm going for. And if it doesn't, honestly, I might just be done with hair extensions because my hair is like decently long. Like, it's not that bad. I mostly just hate, like, my hair is very weird. Like, I feel like it like has lots of weird little like wavy, weird flippy things that it does, and I don't really like it. This is what it looks like from the back. I don't know how well, actually I can see in my mirror here, that's actually not too bad. So I'm trying to like get into this. So yeah, here is my hair currently in the state that it's at. I don't really like, so basically I'm trying to grow out my bangs right here. So it's kind of like short in the front, but it's very like weird and kind of like, it just falls really weird. I don't like how my hair falls, but I'd be a lot happier if like my bang area was as long as like this is. Like if it was all just one length, I think I would like that a lot more. But yeah, this is what we are dealing with for now. And we're just gonna go ahead and get into this and hopefully it goes okay. Usually when I dye my hair, I just kind of glob it on my head anyways. I don't really do it like super like professionally or anything, but I will have to be careful with the black not getting onto the purple. And also my roots are kind of grown in a little bit on the purple side that you can really see, but I don't really care. I don't want to bleach my roots or anything. I'm going to wait like at least till they're grown out to like here. All right, so this is pretty much all of the tools that I have that I think I'll need. So I have the conditioner that I'm going to use to dilute my Manic Panic. I have two mixing bowls, a hair dye brush. I got a couple clips. I have a comb just in case to help me separate the sections of my hair, some hair ties, my black dye, my Manic Panic, and a brush. And I think that that's everything that I will need.
Diamond eyes, I know it won't be hard. I might look strong, but I can fall apart. I hope you know I'm made from broken parts. I see you there. I watch you go. Into the darkness. At least I know.
Rinsed out now. I wasn't able to film me rinsing it out because It was just a disaster trying to set up my camera, but it really wasn't that exciting. But this is how it looks wet. So yeah, it's looking nice and black and fresh. And then this is the purple side. It's pretty much like the same kind of purple that I had, but it's just like refreshed kind of. So nothing super crazy over there, but I like it a lot. I know I mentioned that I wasn't sure if I was gonna do these or not. I don't think I am, just because, like I was saying, I don't really wanna put like too much stuff in my hair in one day. Like, I feel like dyeing it and then like putting it in another thing and rinsing it out again, and I already did like a hair mask and stuff. I just don't want to do too many products at once because I don't really know. I feel like this one's probably like kind of intensive. Like it's not just like I'm gonna use this, I'm gonna use the serum, because that's just like a basic like product that I can put in my hair. So I'll let you know how this one is, and then I'll do a video about that one and just kind of how they work together, and if overall I think that they're good. But for now, I'm just gonna, you know, just kind of use it in general. So I'm just gonna put about a pump into my hand. Ooh, feels like a serum. And I'm just gonna put this on. I don't even know what it says. Like, usually I put this on damp hair. Let's see what it says. After applying Dream Length Sleek Shampoo and Conditioner, apply 1 to 2 pumps on damp hair before blow drying. Once dry, flat iron. To tame static and frizz, apply a small amount on dry hair. So yeah, I'm using this on damp hair, and mostly focusing it on the ends of my hair, but I do kind of use like whatever's left over just to kind of put on the top too. But that's pretty much all that I'm doing. I might put a little bit more. It said 1 to 2 pumps, so I'm putting half a pump more, and I'm just gonna kind of really focus it onto the ends of my hair kind of deal, just to make sure it's nice. And then I'm gonna be blow drying my hair next, and we can see what this looks like when it's fully dry. So I'm just using this random Conair blow dryer that I got from the drugstore, and then I have this really weird brush that I got from my work for free a while ago, but it has like kind of like ventilation through it, and I've been really liking this to blow dry my hair. And then towards the end, when it's like kind of more dry, I might use a combination of these two brushes. So a round brush, and then this one's really good. It has like boar bristles. It's really good for like smoothing it out. So you might see me using a few different brushes while I do this. I usually just try to do it on like the medium heat setting and like the full like blast of air. Okay, so here's my hair completely finished. It is completely dry. I think it turned out really, really well. It's nice and black, and I really like how the iron color brilliance turned out, and I wasn't really sure how it would. And then this is the purple. Not too exciting, but it's something. At least it's refreshed and looking good. My extensions are not dry yet, so I'm not gonna be trying them on in this video, but yep, here it is, just natural. I also wanted to put on one more little bit of this now that my hair is dry, because it said that you can put it on dry hair as well. So I just want to see how that feels going on dry hair. Kind of just like any other serum, nothing like super crazy. Yeah, I've always really, really liked serums. I find that they're very nice. They make your hair feel very soft and shiny. Well, I guess it can't feel shiny, but you know what I mean. Yeah, I'm just gonna brush that through. But I think I like it. I'll have to use it for a few days to know for sure, but I think I do like that stuff. And this is it from the back. Here, I'll like brush it out for you guys. There it is. I don't know what it looks like from the back, but hopefully it's all right. Yep. There it is.